Alright, so the next thing on our list is to head to Trino and turn in the Stellazio coins. Now, in addition to the Stellazio coins, there is also a new monster we can fight at the weapon shop, but we're not really ready to fight it at this point, because it's a behemoth. Wait, this just leads to the auction house, doesn't it? No, it doesn't. I will indeed give you Pisces. And Gil. A Rosetta ring. $30,000 gil. And a robe of lords. Nice. Something is missing, huh? There is one more Stellazio coin. Okay, then. Now, I do know where the 13th coin is, but before we do that, we need to be heading to the auction house. If I can remember how to get there, that is. Oh wait, I remember how to get there now. Hopefully I have enough money to buy it, but if not, I may be out of luck at this point. Rat tail, Doga's artifact, a magical fingertip, and dark matter. Alright, I don't need the rat tail at the moment. Thank you. You're really duking it out over this rat tail. Alright, we got Doga's artifact again. Now the magical fingertip is the one I need. And I think this one can get rather pricey. I really want that thing. And it's mine. Now I would try to go for the Dark Matter because that teaches Garnet Odin. But since I'm not using Garnet anyway, and because it can get crazy expensive, it may not be worth getting. Well, maybe I can get it. Nice! Last thing I want is an Une's mirror if I can. Fairy earrings I don't really need. it's mine. No one knows who this Go-Go guy is. He just disappeared. Does he really exist or what? Now, Go-Go is a reference to... it's both a boss from Final Fantasy V and a secret character from Final Fantasy VI. Now, we didn't really need Doga's artifact or Uni's mirror again, but... if we take them to the Black Mage Village, something different will happen when we head to the Chocobo Shack. Now, there is something we can do with the magical fingertip, but first let's complete the Stellazio coin quest. Last coin is at Quan's dwelling. And it's actually in the same exact spot. Excuse me. It's in the same exact spot that one of the previous Stellazio coins was at. Something under where the Scorpio used to be. Received Ophiuchus? I think that's how you pronounce it anyway. Their future was uncertain, but Scorpio and Virgo kissed in the light of dusk. That moment meant everything. So it was Scorpio that ended up with Virgo. Okay, that's all the Stellazio coins for real this time, so let's go give them to Queen Stella. Alright, Queen Stella, I have all 13 Stellazio coins for you. received a hammer. Just what I always wanted. Now, believe it or not, this is actually Cinna's hammer. Why Queen Stella actually had it, I'll never know, but there you go. Nobody can actually equip it, and you can't really do anything with it. However, once we get to the final dungeon, there is a secret synthesis shop that we can eventually get to that we can use it to synthesize tin armor for Steiner, I believe. Or, if we hold on to it, there's like a little bonus thing we can get in the final cutscenes of the game. I mean, apparently just having the hammer doesn't really change much in the final cutscenes. It's barely noticeable as well, so I might make the armor for Steiner, but I'm not sure yet. Okay, so that's the Stellazio side quest out of the way. Now we need to head back to Duero again and give this magical fingertip to someone. Think this is the guy that wants it? I do indeed. Yeah, I'll give it to you. Oh, did you know? Years ago, I read a biography of a great craftsman named Gogo who was known for making dolls that looked like real people. Supposedly, the secret to his extraordinary skill was in his fingers. Aw, he wanted to make a doll of his wife. Received Excalibur. Ooh. Right, so that's a new weapon for Steiner, which unfortunately it's not as powerful as the Ragnarok. But it does have an elemental attack of holy, so that's cool. It does teach him Klim Hazard as well. I do like that he gets to learn General Beatrix's attacks at least. So we got the Excalibur. Okay, there's just one more thing I want to show you in this part, and then I'm gonna be leaving you guys for a while. Thank you. It's not really a side quest I'm showing you, it's just something kind of neat that you can find if you have Doga's Artifact and Une's Mirror. Let's see if this will work. Maybe it's not in here. Let's look somewhere else. I know there's a phonograph in one of these houses. Now, if you've played Final Fantasy III, this tune is probably very familiar. This is Doga and Une's theme. So that was pretty cool. So I'm pretty sure that every Final Fantasy has had some kind of reference in this game now. Alright, you guys. So, what I've got to do now is I've got to do some major leveling off-screen. I've got to get my party members to about level 60-ish, probably around level 61 if possible, because we're going to be taking an optional boss on. You know what's coming. It's Ozma. Now, I'm not sure if I'm going to do the friendly monster quest. I didn't do it last time, and Ozma proved to be quite tough, but maybe I'll do it this time, I'm not sure yet. At any rate, I'm gonna be leaving you guys for a while I go level. So, I'll see you then, guys.